Hello children, I am your teacher, Mrs. Joyce Shepherd. I will be teaching you English for class 2. I hope you are studying at home and not going out anyway, as it is necessary for us to fight against COVID-19. I welcome you all to class 2. Children, today I am going to teach you chapter 1 of English literature. The name of the chapter is Too Big, Too Small. First of all, let me explain to you the meaning of too big and too small. So children, I will give you two simple examples. For example, number one, horse, elephant, kangaroo, zebra, etc., etc. These animals are very big in size. Number two, rabbit, ant, butterfly, etc., etc. These animals are very small. Now, have you understood both the meanings? Now, let me tell you about the story. This story is about a mother and her daughter. So, let's start with the reading of the chapter, and you have to repeat after me. I can't lift you up, Sanu, says Ammi. You are too big. You can't walk to school alone, Sanu, says Abbu. You are too small. So now children, I will start with the explanation. Oh, what is Ammi saying? Ammi is saying, Sanu, I can't lift you in my arms because you are too big. That means she is not able to carry Sanu in her arms because she is very big. Now, what is Abbu saying? Abbu is saying, Sanu, you are not able to go to school alone because you are too small. And small kids don't go to school alone. Do you go to school alone? No, na? You can't sleep in the baby's cot, Sanu, says Dadu. You are too big. You can't carry the baby to the park, Sanu, says Dadi. You are too small. Okay children, what is a baby's cot? Have you all seen a baby's cot? It is also called palna in Hindi, where babies sleep when they are small. You all are at your own homes, right? Ask your mother, have you ever slept on a baby's cot? She must have said yes. But can you sleep in that baby's cot now? No, because you are too big. Same Dadu is saying to Sanu that you can't sleep in the baby's cot because you are too big. Same way, Dadi is saying to Sanu that you are too small to carry the baby to the park. So here again, Sanu is getting confused, or you can even say puzzled. Sometimes Sanu is listening that she is very big. Sometimes she is too small. So here Ammi is saying, Sanu, you are too big. But Abbu is saying, Sanu, you are too small. So at some point Sanu is very big, but at some point also Sanu is very small. So what is happening here? Sanu is getting confused. Sanu doesn't even know, is she big or is she small? Sanu is puzzled. Too big, too small. How can she be both? Too big to wear her old pink frock, but too small to make dosas on the stove. Now, let me explain here again. Sanu is puzzled. Now, do you know the meaning of puzzled? I'll tell you. Puzzle means not sure about what is right and what is not. Okay, let me give you the example. Here, Sanu is puzzled. Sanu is getting confused. Is she big or is she small? Basically, puzzle means when you are comparing two things. Here, Sanu is confused between big and small. She can't understand whether is she big or is she small. So Sanu gets puzzled again. Now, how can she be both? So Sanu is thinking, how can I be both? I can be small, I can be big. So she is getting very confused. Too big to wear her old pink frock, but too small to make dosas on the stove. Now Sanu is saying, I'm very big to wear my old frock. Okay, tell me children, can you wear your old clothes? No, nah, because it will not fit you. But you are too small to make dosas. Now, you tell me children, do you help your mother in the kitchen? No, nah, because you are too big to climb up on Dadu's back, but too small to carry the baby on hers. Now Sanu is saying, I am that big that I can't climb up on my Dadu's back. But now you tell me, do you do it now? I know your answer is no, because now you are too big. Your Dadu and Dadi can't carry you on their back. But you are too small to carry the baby on hers, because baby is very small and you are also very small. So how can you carry the baby on your arms? So you tell me, how do you carry a baby? We have to carry a baby very carefully, because babies are very soft and you are very small. If you carry a baby, he or she might get hurt. Yes or no? Yes, because the baby is very small. So you are not able to carry the baby in the right way. What am I the right size for? Sanu wonders. Ami smiles and says, "You are just big enough to go to school, and you are just small enough for me to carry you on my shoulders," says Abu. Now Sanu gets all confused again. Sometimes her father is telling her that she is too big, and sometimes her mother tells her that she is too small. Everyone starts smiling. Then her ummi, which means her mother, tells her that you are just big enough to go to school. And her father tells her that you are just small enough for me to carry you on my shoulders. You are just big enough to take me for morning walks, says Dadu. And you are just small enough for me to tell stories too, says Dadi. And you will always, always be the perfect size for this. They all say and give her a warm, wonderful hug. Okay, children, let me explain the last part of the paragraph. Now, children, you tell me, when you go home, do you go for a walk with your grandfather? Yes or no? Yes, na? Many of you go for a walk with your grandfather, which means Dadu. Same way, Sanu used to go for a walk with her Dadu and her grandmother, which means Dadi, told her she is just small enough to listen to her stories. Do your grandmother tells you stories in the night at bedtime? Yes, na? Then everyone in her family, her mother, father, grandfather and grandmother, gave her a warm, wonderful hug and kissed her and told her, you will always, always be the perfect size. So children, when you grow into a young boy, girl or an adult, but for your parents, you will always remain the perfect size. All right, children, I would like you all to go through the full chapter thoroughly and do all the exercise given below.